guys, welcome to another episode of Athletes Uncensored. Today I have Taylor Averill with me, aka Sunny, UH alumni. You were like an All-American or something, right? Yeah, great. USA middle blocker and my good pal for so long now. It's crazy. Yeah, I'm super stoked to have you on the show today. As per usual, my guests have no clue what's going on this show. But today we're playing a little game called Firing Questions.
Somebody call 911. Shoddy fire.
And to be clear, you do have the rights to be playing the song and will not be sued by any sort of record company.
What's up, Quad?
So my first question for you, Sunny. We've been friends now for some years since college. And I kind of just want to start on a serious note. I know it was probably really difficult for you, but recently you had to shave your mustache. So can you just please tell the people, you know, how you're feeling, how you mentally are handling this?
Oh, yeah. I think I was pretty distraught at first, and I made a huge mistake. I don't know why I thought people would be backing me up in wanting to. Basically, I did a USA Volleyball takeover, and one of the things I said was, should I shave my mustache? Just assuming it would be 100-0. And I was wrong, and I had to shave it, and it was a sad moment. And I can't believe I'm about to say this, but I think I kind of like it without it.
What?
It was just kind of like a new – it's funny how something that was, like, barely there in the first place could make such a big impact on who I was. Turns out, I kind of like the new look.
Yeah, you're just like a whole other person.
The new look, it's like all 10 hairs did so much for me. Like, mentally, they did, you know? Like – when I went to Hawaii, we couldn't have facial hair. You couldn't have any hair touching your ears and no facial hair. And I think I was just so upset about it that it was like my life mission to never shave it after I left that place. And now look at me, you know.
Yeah, you're just living your best life now with long hair.
And life now. Absolutely.
Okay, so I don't know if like people know this at all, but you're kind of into stand-up comedy, right?
Sure, yeah, yeah.
Do you have, like, any plans of being on tour soon? Like, do you need a manager? Like, I can manage you if you need that. You know, just give the people what they want. They want to see you.
Honestly. I hear what you're trying to say. Look, I had knee surgery this last year and didn't go overseas. And one of the things I wanted to do was put my time into something that I never thought I'd have time for. And so I signed up for a stand-up comedy class. And did that for 8 weeks. And the class was kind of whatever. But it did teach me a lot, and it was a lot of fun. And I enjoyed the experience. It's super fun writing and thinking in that way. I think the cool thing is, like, anything you choose to do, whether it's like photography or stand-up comedy or whatever, it's like if you choose to do something, your brain starts to function through that perspective. And so I just like living in that world where, like, everything's a joke and, you know, you're just aware. I feel like I'm aware of little details that I would normally miss. And yeah, with that being said, it was a cool experience, but the road to being like an actual stand-up comedian is a lot of bars at 2 a.m. with three people in the audience. And look, volleyball can be a lonely enough lifestyle. I don't need anything else to put me farther in the hole. it's just a fun hobby. I still like write things down and yeah. It's the best part about living in this house right now is everyone has that similar mindset. So this house is just a frat joke house right now. It's amazing.
Okay, so we're friends on Instagram, and I would see your stuff when you're overseas. Did you have, like, an affair with Baguettes or something like that?
Yeah, so I started this joke, basically, that all the Baguettes in France were being held captive, and it was our responsibility as the people to free those Baguettes. And it started as, like, a joke. Because this small town I lived in France, everywhere I went, people had Baguettes. Like, you'd walk on the street and people were just walking with Baguettes. I was taking videos of people. There was a guy on a bike who had a roller backpack and just two Baguettes sticking out of the roller backpack. And it started to get so ridiculous that I was like, you know what, we're going to take this joke as far as possible. And the whole, like, French community loved it. So I just kept doing it and got so much feedback. And to this day, I still get people who send me videos. So, next year I'll be playing in Cannes in France again. And let's just say there's some exciting things coming for those people who believed in Free the Baguette.
That is huge. I feel like that could be its own, like, being. Like, that's its own beast. Like, own Instagram page, own reality TV show. Like, these baguettes living their best life.
Wow. Reality TV show might be a bit much, but I will say I did get the Instagram account. There are things coming, and I'm super excited. Yeah, I'm going to hopefully make some, like, T-shirts and hats, and, yeah, it'll be cool.
Link below. Here's the link if you need it, if you want it.
Hopefully by the time this airs, there will be a link below you can click on.
It's coming out next week, so probably not.
But. Sick, probably definitely not then.
What historical figure would you want to meet?
Probably Napoleon.
Why?
He would have got along really well. Like, Dennis Rodman is, like, really good friends with Kim Jong-un. And I feel like me and Napoleon would have been like that. Like, we're such opposites that we would have just become best friends.
Yeah, because he was, like, negative in height also.
Right. He had a little attitude, and I'm more of, like, a chiller. I think we would have been a good couple, actually.
Yeah, you guys would be really cute together.
I think we'd be really cute together. I agree.
Yeah. What's your favorite celebrity to do an impression of? And let's see it.
I'm gonna do the scene, and you're just gonna tell me what you think it is.
Oh God.
Okay. Two mice fall into a bucket of cream. The first mouse, he quickly gives up and he drowns. But the second mouse, he struggles so hard that eventually he churns that cream into butter and he walks on out. I'm proud to tell you that I am that second mouse.
There it is, people. His debut.
You know who it is? Do you know what movie it's from?
I don't. I'm sorry.
No? That's Christopher Walken from Catch Me If You Can.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. I think Christopher Walken's my favorite impression because every time I do that little spoof all the time in this house, and they all say that I have the worst Christopher Walken impression. So that's my favorite one.
That's great.
Yeah.
You got to open with the worst because then it can only get better.
Yeah, and it's also my go-to speech. I've given that speech at weddings, at, you know, restaurant microphones, kind of just anywhere I can. I give that speech.
You got to spread the love of that.
Yeah.
It's a great message.
Recognition. And I just enjoy it. It's short. It's easy. There's a message. And that's really what speeches are about.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
Do you ever wear headbands when you play?
No. And people should be shamed for wearing headbands. I won't do it. No amount of convincing, no amount of Instagram polls will ever get me to wear a headband in a game.
I like can respect that, but I also just really want to see it.
Yeah.
That's just my personal.
No, you're not the only one.
Yeah. Like if anybody could do it, it's for sure you.
And yet if there's anybody who shouldn't do it, it's for sure me.
What's something that you thought you would have done that you haven't done yet?
Written a book.
Nice.
Yeah. I mean, I still have time, you know. I told myself, I wrote down when I was like 20 years old that I wanted to write a book by 30. And it's really easy to not write a book. That's what I do now. It's really easy not to write a book. In fact, I had this, there was a point in my life where I was living month to month. And I started finding ways to survive on not a lot of money. And so I wanted to make a book called Bum Tips. And then my goal was to give it out to the homeless community, like write all these tips. And then I had a point where I would like, there was like a homeless community in Hawaii that lived near where I parked my moped. And I gave them all journals and I wanted them to just like write things down and write thoughts down. And then I would come once a week and collect them. And I gave out the journals and within 3 days, the police came and moved them. So they're out there writing a journal that will never be collected and therefore never be in the book. And that's why I haven't written it.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Wow, that's
so Bum Tips is definitely out now, but it was, you know, it was like pretty simple stuff, kind of like how to get free samples for free, how to kind of get things for free, be a little bit of a gypsy, and just things you got to do when you don't got a lot of money, you know, legal thing.
Wow, that's really cool.
Yeah, it would have been a cool idea, actually. I was thinking pop-up, like 3D pop-up too, interactive a little bit, maybe.
Nice.
Probably a bad idea, but I would have done it.
Yeah, you got to commit to it. That's great. You should like definitely do something like that in the future. Some sort.
I would love to write a book, just to have written a book.
Right.
Before I do that, I should probably finish a book. I need to learn to read the whole book first before I can write my own.
Right. You know,
but that's my biggest problem is writing or reading a full book. I'll read like halfway through books and just stop for no good reason. I loved it. I was in. I was, you know, I was committed. and then just wouldn't follow through. I don't know why.
Yeah, I feel like I kind of had that same problem with a few books. Like, maybe because, like, in the back of my mind, I'm like, oh, I don't want this book to end, so I'll just save it for later.
Dude, honestly, look, I'm not here to blame the school system, but I am saying, like, reading never seemed like a fun thing to me. It was always like, I'm assuming that so much of my past life was, you have to read this by this certain time, that once I became an adult, I was just like, no, I don't. And now look at me, I'm just a big dummy who can't finish a book, so.
But you're going to be a writer. You're going to be an author, so.
Yeah, we're all authors.
Yeah, exactly. We're all writing our own unique stories.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my God.
Get it.
You'll love to see it.
You'll love to see it.
What's your most irrational fear?
Some would say it's a very rational fear. But my most irrational fear is flooding the house again with my own poop. When I was 12, so I was always known as the thunder pooper in our house. I don't know why, I just pooped a lot. And I still do.
That says that. I feel like you need a t-shirt with that on it.
Thunder poop with just little poops.
Yeah.
Going down. Yep. Let's just say that will definitely be in the category I've never made. Good idea, though. But basically, when I was 12, I pooped in the house, and everyone was in the living room. I lived in, like, a small, normal home. And bathroom was in the back. I pooped, thought I had done everything correctly. I went through all the steps that I go through since I was a child. I go to the living room. We're all watching a movie or something out there. And the next thing you know, we just see water leaking through the hallway. And we're like, what? And I opened the door. And somehow I clogged the toilet enough to where it just kept coming out. And there were just little poops floating on the carpet. And the whole house got flooded. Like, dude, no one saw it for like an hour at least. And the whole house got flooded. And we had to stay at a hotel for like 3 or 4 days. And to this day, I still have this fear. Like, when I flush the toilet, I watch the water go down. And then I watch it come up. And I need to watch it stop before I can close the lid and wash my hands.
Every time.
Pretty much every time. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. And I poop like at least twice a day. So it consumes a lot of my thoughts.
Wow, you have great bowel movements.
Dude, I don't know what I'm doing over here, but doing something either right or wrong. I don't know.
Yeah. Oh my God, that's hilarious. Yeah.
Since it's actually happened, I guess maybe it is a rational fear, you know?
For sure.
It's rational to think that it could happen again.
Absolutely. Who's the last person you texted that didn't text back?
Well, this is not the way to answer this question, but... I'm that guy. If anything, I'm the guy that didn't text.
Oh my God, you are. It was like freaking trying to corral cats getting you on this
thing. It sucks. I'm more like, if you would have called me, I would have answered. I'm just so much more like any sort of, anything that's not like joking, fun conversation to me is like, I'm so much better if like, I just get on the phone with somebody.
For sure. I like that.
Yeah, I'm just not a good, God, it's such a cop-out to say, like, you're not a good texter, or I try to get better. I just, like, next thing you know, I'm having a conversation with, like, 4 or 5 different people, and they're responding quickly, and it's just, like, too overwhelming, so I'm just, like, I'm just not going to deal with it until I really think of something good to say, or they call me.
Yeah.
Or I call them. That's why I call most of my friends, too. I'm not a big texting guy.
I like that better, actually, like, just picking up the phone and calling someone, like, you cover all the bases and more than just texting. It's great.
Yeah, I think so too.
If you had a fragrance, what would it be called?
Spice melange.
Can you please elaborate on that one?
I won't. That's a one-word answer you're getting. 2 words, actually. Spice melange.
How would the label look?
There would be no label.
You just know.
You just know.
Like, it's a rectangular blank, like, that's it.
It's shapeless. It's formless. It doesn't even have a scent, but it's like you walk by someone who's wearing it, and you're like, that's it. Spice melange.
Coming to you soon.
Spice melange. And I would want it to be auburn. What? I want it to be auburn. The shape and the color and everything is auburn. That's what I'm thinking of.
That's great.
Yeah.
It'll be in Target or?
No, you won't be able to buy it.
Oh, but like people.
You have to know a guy or a girl.
Right.
It would be unisex.
Got it.
You get where I'm going, though. It's a great idea, I think.
Picking up what you're putting down. What's a lie that you recently told?
Oh, I'm busy all the time. I tell it to everyone all the time. I'm not.
I'm not.
Yeah, that's an easy one.
A movie you wish you had been in.
Remember the Titans. I was Sunshine. That character was based on me. And yeah, they found someone else to play.
That's a shame.
That is.
You're probably like 5 also when the movie came out.
I was 5, which is crazy that they kind of knew how I would turn out at that age. But
it's insane. They like probably saw you and they're like, this is that kid's future. Like, here you go.
Yeah. And so I guess I'll forever be grateful for that.
What's something that you hate that everyone loves?
Those trendy shoes, dude. Those shoes, they're like little dinosaur shoes. You know what I'm talking about?
They're like big fluffy ones.
They're like real trendy, especially out here in LA. I can never describe them because I don't even know how, other than dinosaur shoes. I don't know who said that. I did not make that up. They're like big and puffy. They're from like the 90s, maybe like 90s Nike Air kind of shoe. Do you know what I'm talking about? You have to know. Everybody knows.
Yeah, they're like the thick puffy ones.
I hate them, dude. I hate them. I hate that everything, it feels like everything out here in LA becomes like super trendy, super fast. And then it's not even, everywhere I go, everybody's wearing them and they're not cool anymore.
They're doing it like in spite of you. Like they know you don't like it. So.
And obviously I don't think Ben Patch will ever hear this, but if he does, he has some of those shoes and I've worn them. They are really comfortable. So I'll give, if people are wearing them for the comfort, then I get it. But for the trend, Come on.
You're invited to a dinner party. What do you bring?
Depends whose dinner. Whose dinner? Rapid fire question for you. Whose dinner is it that I'm invited to?
Whose dinner that you're invited to? Oh.
Someone I love, someone random, a neighbor.
Beyonce.
Oh my God, dude. Beyonce is getting a handwritten haiku with custom photo on the back of me and her that I've inserted my face into where Jay-Z is.
Right.
Yeah. And then I probably wouldn't make it to dinner. I'd give her the card. She'd be so disappointed in me and probably still be confused of why I even was there. Like she doesn't even know me. But that's what I'd bring.
But she knows you from Remember the Titans. Is the
thing. Well, she remembers me from Remember the Titans.
Yeah. Right.
Come on.
My apologies. If you had one celebrity that you wanted to like hang out with for the day, who would it be? And also, who's your celebrity crush?
Childhood celebrity crush was Hayden Panettiere. I think that's how you say her name. I loved her as a kid. I've always had a weakness for blondes, so that still stands. But if I could go to like have a day with a celebrity, it would be Larry David. He's the creator of Seinfeld. He has his own show called Curb Your Enthusiasm. The guy, the way his mind works is just like incredible. I would love to just get a sneak peek at how that brain functions.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Shout out, if you hear this, Larry, please let us know.
Yeah. If you hear it, call me. Text me. He's probably one guy I would probably text back. Too fast to the point that he'd probably even be like, okay, you know, we just met. You need to text me back so fast.
What is the most posh thing about you?
I'm recently becoming more, I guess, posh. I got a skincare routine that I don't follow, but I did buy the little like charcoal and there's another moisturizer for my face because I'm in the sun a lot and I don't really wear sunscreen. And I just feel like I'm gonna regret it in 10 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm trying to do a little more.
Kids, learn that now. Sunscreen.
I got a question for you. Okay, and for all the girls out there, mainly women, who use that like, it's like a roller that you use on your face, and it's like a rock.
Yeah.
I've tried a couple of those. Those are pretty cool. I don't know if they work or not, but they are fun to do. So are the little eye things that go under your eye.
Yeah.
You put them in the fridge. Mm-hmm. And those are amazing. I got that from my ex-girlfriend, Hayden. Those are amazing. You know, I have a best friend named Ben Patch, who's very posh, and he's going to hate me for saying that, but he has bled into my life some of the great posh things, and because of that, I have outfits now, Before, I just kind of was like, whatever is nearest to me, I'll put that on. And now things hang in the closet and I make decisions now before
wow,
I go out.
That's a huge step in life, I think.
It is. And it's brand new to me, so it's exciting.
That's exciting. Thanks, yeah. Ben Patch. We appreciate you. The people appreciate you.
Yep, they do.
Ridiculous thing you're afraid of.
There's a skunk and he's been walking down our steps. I live in this house up here. And there's a ton of nature around here. It's actually pretty cool. There's like tons of green and trees and plants. And the problem with that is there's a lot of nature animals and everybody loves nature animals, especially skunks. They look so cute, but they're not. And there's this skunk that comes out in front of the house like every night around like 10 or 11 o'clock. I don't know if that's when he's allowed to go out or not, but it's like the same time. And I never really seen a skunk in person, you know? Like, I remember being a kid and you drive by and it'd smell and everyone's goes, skunk, it smells like skunk. But I never even really seen one in person. Not even at a zoo. They didn't even have them in zoos. And this was a wild skunk who hangs out here and I'm legitimately terrified. Like, absolutely terrified of it. And the other night I was hanging out in front of the door and I broke the washing machine, so I had to hang all the clothes over the railing. That's a whole other story. I made a huge mistake. And as I'm doing that, I look to the right and there's a skunk, like, 3 feet from me, and he just locks eyes with me. And they don't really tell you in school, or there's no pamphlet you can go pick up on how to interact when a skunk sees you. And I was terrified, and I just slowly backed away, and I opened the door, and I got in the house, and I shut the door, and I started filming it because I was so scared. And now every night, every time it gets dark around here, I walk up the steps, like, to get into the garage or to go wherever, and so slowly and always looking for them, or I'll go in the backyard to eat dinner and I'm just like looking around. I'm terrified. The thing has consumed all my thoughts at night.
Wow.
Yeah, it's crazy. So I don't know if you have any information on what you're supposed to do. Are you supposed to not break eye contact? Is it like do you act like you're big? Do you act friendly? I don't know, they got long tails.
You know, I just think if you dress up as a skunk when you're walking around your property, he might leave you alone. So, like, that could be an option for you.
Yeah. Or I think it would work if I was, like, I don't know, 3 feet smaller.
Maybe. But you could be, like, their leader. They're like, oh, my gosh, that's the big one.
Maybe I'll just start carrying a staff with me past 9 o'clock. I wonder how they'll respond to that.
Yeah.
But I'm terrified. If anyone's listening and this just becomes some huge thing, please contact me. I refuse to just simply Google it. I'd prefer to know through word of mouth.
You heard it here first, people. Let them know.
Let me know.
For all of the nature animals as compared to non-nature animals.
Specifically the skunk, though, in this case.
Yes. If you were to name a strain of marijuana after your love life, what would it be?
It would be, oops, I did it again.
That's pretty classic. That's pretty classic.
Yeah. So maybe in that case, you would call it toxic, or even like Britney. Britney's back, maybe something like that, just to like try to keep it short and catchy.
Yeah.
Oops, I did it again would be more relative to me.
There you go. There you go. That's also coming to you too. So many branding ideas have come out of this. You know, all the links will be below. So. If you were in art school and got to sculpt a celebrity, who would it be?
Beyonce.
Beyonce.
You need a lot of clay to be sculpting Beyonce, you know what I mean?
Always.
You need a lot of clay.
A lot of clay.
Which is actually cool. It's so funny you bring that up. I just met, I'm like on the neighborhood watch now because I just work out in this garage all day. So I've met all the neighbors who live around here. And I just met a guy who I'm going to train his kid, actually, which is kind of cool. But... He's a sculptor. He sculpts for the entertainment business. So that's like what it does for his job.
That's so cool.
Yeah. So I've thought about asking him for like, I'll train his kid and he'll teach me how to sculpt something.
Yeah.
I don't know. I have like one sip of coffee and then my hands start going like this. I'm afraid right. I screw everything up. But that'd be a cool thing to get into.
Yeah. Well, cool. Anything else? Yeah.
I am coming up with, I've been developing with a guy I learned from at Hawaii, some workout stuff. So we got kind of like a new methodology and we're working on packaging it to deliver to the volleyball community. Some stuff that completely changed my life at Hawaii. So I'm super, super excited to announce when that will be coming out. Otherwise, TAverill13 is my Instagram. Come check me out, dude. check me out, like and subscribe, and don't comment on anything because I don't want to know. If you really care, send me a DM and I'll take a couple days to respond.
Maybe.
Maybe.
If you're
yeah.
All right, guys. Well, thanks, Sunny, so much for being here. I'm sure that you made a couple people chuckle during all this. But yeah, I was super stoked to have you on. So thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me. This is such an honor. I'm excited. I hope you do a lot with this. I think it's a really cool idea. I really do like it.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Awesome, guys. Well, like, subscribe, comment. Let me know like what kind of questions or games that you want to see via Zoom, since that's all we can do right now. But yeah, we'll see you here next time.